Now we are switching over to detailed electronic configuration. Say, when I am talking about electronic configuration here, we discuss that KLM, etc., or shell number 1, shell number 2, shell number 3, and so on. But we observed certain problems in that. And for that purpose, we are switching over to this different model of electronic configuration. We are calling that as Aufbau principle. This is German word, meaning is to fill up. So we are going to fill up electrons here, the principle that was given by Niels Bohr. In order to get idea of this Niels Bohr's model or SPDF level electronic configuration, we should discuss further that when we are having a shell is divided into subshells. Say for example, shell number 5, it is divided into subshell as SPDF. So first subshell is S, second is P, third is D, and fourth is F. So like that, for every shell, say n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, like that, for every shell, there are subshells as S, P, D, F. So, we should be more clear this way, that initially, I am saying the name of shell as K, L, M, N, and so on. But we are aware that K, that means N equal to 1. L, that means n equal to 2. What is n? N is principal quantum number or main shell number. Here we are getting n equal to 3. Here we are getting n equal to 4. And so on. Whereas subshells, they are called as S, P, D, and F. Now it is not necessary that all subshells should be present in K or L, but these are numbers of subshells present in every shell, means for K there is S, P, and so on. Actually these are the numbers. If zero number is there, we are calling that as S. P, that is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. I can't write electronic configuration like that. N equal to 1, that is first shell, then it is 0, and then number of electron. You may read this as 10 square. In order to eliminate this confusion, this zero number is given as S. So what I am writing here, I am writing this way, 1s and then 2. So I am now clear that when I am writing 1s2, what is the meaning of that? The main shell is 1, subshell, that is S, and in that subshell, 2 electrons are there. So that's why I am writing here 2. So this way, main shell is divided into 4 subshells. These subshells are also called as azimuthal quantum number. But right now, I am not interested in teaching you principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, etc. terminology right now. So first, we are focusing on electronic configuration. You are now aware that subshells are divided into that main shell is divided into 4 subshell, that is S, P, D, and F. Now right now forget of these values. So main shells are divided into 4 subshell, they are S, P, D, F. So like that you have to keep in mind. Now here I am writing out subshells in corner, they are S, P, D, F. These subshells are present in every shell, not necessary all, but subshells are only this. And on head of these, we are writing out capacities. Now you are aware of the word capacity. Capacity is maximum number of electron here I can accommodate. So here I am writing 2. While reading, we have to read S2, and don't read out S square. Many students are pronouncing this as S square. This is not S square. This is actually, in chemistry language, we are saying it is S2. Now P. P is having maximum capacity at 6. D is having maximum capacity of 10. And F is having maximum capacity, that is of 14. That means I can accommodate 14 electrons in F, but not 15th electron in F. But I can accommodate 13, 12, 11, 10, any number of electron in F. Why? Because maximum capacity is 14. Now, here I am constructing out a chart. Now, you are aware that various writing systems are there in world. Say, for example, whatever the Indo-European category of languages, usually we are saying Indian languages, that is Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Kannada, etc. They are writing out from left side to right side. In history, you must have studied that in Punjab and Sindh territory, that is in Indus Valley, Persian people introduced a script that is called as Kharoshtri script. That is written from right to left, like Urdu. They are writing out from right and moving towards left. In English, we are writing from left to right. There are certain languages they are writing from, like Japanese or Chinese, I don't know exactly. But they are writing from top to bottom. Okay. But chemistry is something different than that all. Now here, whatever diagram I am giving, I am writing from bottom to top. Getting idea? So first I am writing here 1s. You are aware 1 is principal shell, main shell first, and S. Then I am writing out here 2s. In front of that, I am writing 2p. So I am starting out from bottom and moving towards top. Here I am writing, say, 1 number increased out 3s. Then here 3p. Here 3d. So as spdf, as shells are getting higher and higher, we are adding out one more shell over here. Now 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. Okay, here I want to communicate different message with you, that please take a pen, notebook, and try to write here along with me, because this is very, very fundamental topic in chemistry. If you are getting thorough knowledge, perfect knowledge here, then chemistry is very, very easy for you. Otherwise, no chance. So try to get this concept very clearly. So take out notebook and write down along with me. So 4F, then 5S, 5P, 5D, 5F. Here something should be there, but not of our use right now. So I am maintaining now here only F shell as last. Then it is 6S, 6P, 6D, and 6F. 7S, 7P, 7D, and 7F. You may say, okay, what we have to continue? We can continue 8, 9, 10, and so on. Till what number? Infinite. But practically speaking, this chart is sufficient. Whatever elements, they are naturally occurring in periodic table. Or whatever we are aware, that natural occurring element, you are aware that atomic number 92. Uranium is last naturally occurring element. So here I am writing out this till here. Now I have to connect the chart. Here I should write down this way. This chart is helpful for electronic configuration purpose. So I am making this chart. So it is 1s, 2s. Like that, we are just connecting out a point. Like in Rangoli, we are making out point and then connecting out. Same way, see, I am connecting out point. I means you are also supposed to do the same thing. Now see, we have to start our journey from this point. One, second number, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth. So this way we have to follow. Let us check out slowly and steadily. Now we have this chart, and I hope you have drawn this chart. Otherwise, pause this video and first finish out this drawing of chart, and then we can go for electronic configuration again. So first pause this video, complete the chart, and start out with me again. Ready? So first I have to find out what is electronic configuration of sodium. Now here you are aware that in case of sodium, atomic number is 11 and mass number is 23. While electronic configuration, we have to focus only on electronic configuration, so we have to focus only on Z, that is atomic mass number, atomic number. So that is 11. So there are 11 protons. As 11 protons are there, there are 11 electrons. Now here I have to accommodate 11 electrons. I have to follow this way. So first I should start with here. So I have to write down one S, because my train starts from here and end till here. Only one station is there in between, that is one S. So I am writing here one S. What is the capacity of S? 2. I have 11 electrons. Out of that, 2 electrons I can accommodate here. So I am writing this. How to read? We have to read this 1s2, and don't read 1s square. Now this track is finished. Now switch over to this track and follow this. So on this, there is only one station. Write it down, 2s. How many electrons we can accommodate there? 2. So it is 2. Switch over to third station. Third line, where two stations are there, 2p and 3s. So we are having here 2p. Capacity of p shell, that is 6. So we can accommodate here 6 electrons maximum. Now count out electron, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10. Whereas I am having 11 electrons to fill. So still one more is pending. So after 2p, next station is 3s. So write down 3s. Capacity is 2, but I am having only one electron. So I can fill only one electron. So this way, the new electronic configuration, or according to this Aufbau principle, whatever electronic configuration is there, that is, I am reading out 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So this way we are going to carry out electronic configuration. This is something different than what we discussed in earlier lecture. But if you observe practically, it is no. Why? See, what is this first shell? In first shell, what is the number of electrons? 2. So I am writing here 2. In second shell, these 2 are there in second shell. So what is total number of electrons? Here 2 and here 6. So total is 8. This is third shell. What is number of electron? 1. So electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1 only. But as it is 2, 8, 1, it is split out into this matter. So this way electronic configuration is same, only we have switched over to electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Try to get. Now do one exercise yourself, that calcium. You are aware now atomic number of calcium is 20. So try to carry out electronic configuration of calcium in this manner. Till that, pause this video, and after finishing out your configuration, you can start this video. Now here I am writing calcium. You are aware atomic number 20 and mass number 40, but right now in case of electronic configuration, I have to focus only on atomic number, that is 20. So number of protons 20. As number of protons are 20, number of electrons also 20. So 20 electrons I have to accommodate. Now check out 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. You are aware now 2p6 means 10 electrons. Then 3s capacity is 2. Okay, so 12 electrons, still 8 electrons are there. So after 3s, we have to switch over to next channel where 3p is the station. So I am writing 3p. How can how many electrons? 6. Now check out, it is 10 plus 8, 18. Still 20 means 2 is remainder. So 3p onwards we are switching to 4s and we are getting answer as 4s2. I can accommodate these electrons. Check out with our previous scheme, 2 electrons. In second shell there are 8 electrons. In third shell 8 electrons and fourth shell 2. So it is according to previous scheme only. But we are getting electronic configuration in this fashion. So check out whether your electronic configuration is same or not. Now try to carry out electronic configuration of element yourself. I am giving you structure, giving you element, your management skill as well as chemistry knowledge, both is required here. I am giving you name of element, that is uranium 92, atomic number 235. Try to get electronic configuration yourself first. I hope you must have tired of calculations, but I don't have alternative. We'll check. Say I am starting out here, uranium as atomic number is 92. There are 92 protons. As 92 protons are there, I have to assume there are 92 electrons. I am right now saying 92 electrons are there, and then we are going to discuss. So first thing, I have to accommodate 92 electrons. So I am starting from here, 1s2, next line 2s2, next line after 2s2 we are getting 2p. So in next line I am going to 2p6, 3s2, because as abundant electrons are there, I should not worry about that initially. After 3s, next line 3p, 6 electrons I can accommodate. Again 4s2, then 3d, capacity of d is 10, then 4p6, 5s2. Now this is the end of my first series. I have to make total here. So 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10, 12, 18, 20, 30, 36, 38. So out of 92, I have arranged 38 electrons over here. Once again, I want to check 10, 20, 30, 38. Now after 5s, go for Higgs bin. So there is 4d, 10. After 4d10, it is 5p6, then 6s2. Now next 4f, you are aware capacity of f is 14, so write down 14 electrons. After 4p we are getting 5d10, then 6p6, then 7s2. I am making end over here. So check out, it is 10 plus 6, 16, 18, 18 plus 4, 22 plus 10, 32, 42, 48, 50. So I have accumulated here 50 electrons. Make total 50 plus 38, that is 88. Remainder 4. So after 7s, whatever is the shell, that is 5f. You are aware capacity of 5f is 14, but I have only 4 electrons, so accommodated 4 electrons. If I am adding out here 4, so it is 12, 9. So 92 electrons are added over here. So this is the electronic configuration of uranium. I hope you must have tired but made it correctly. Check out, I am just moving out of the frame, just check out that your electronic configuration is same as I have carried out. Now, after this electronic configuration, what I want to tell you is something different. Say, this is first reading. In second reading, we have to make rearrangement. I am now rearranging the term as I want to arrange 1, 2, 3 simultaneously. Check out with me. It is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, then 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 4f14. Check out, all these are present. Yes. Then 5s2, 5p6, 5d10, and 5f. But 5f is incomplete. It is 4. Check out next 6. So 6s2 is present. 6s2, 6p6. But 6d is absent. Then 7, 7s2. But 7p is not there. I am just rearranging the term. On rearrangement of term, it is very clear for you that first shell to fourth shell, all shells are completely filled. Whereas fifth shell is incompletely filled, sixth is incompletely filled, and seventh is incompletely filled. So these three shells are incompletely filled, whereas first four shells are completely filled. Now, this is, I am calling as, this is the last shell. This is second last shell, and this is third last shell. That is in my simple English. But what the English they are using over here, they are saying this is ultimate shell. So instead of last, what word we are using here? Ultimate. So this is ultimate shell. Instead of second last, we are using word as penultimate. So this is last shell, no, what we have to call it as ultimate shell. This is second last shell, no, we have to call it as penultimate shell. This is third last shell, no, we have to call it as pre-penultimate shell. Revise. Ultimate, penultimate, pre-penultimate. It's simple. Ultimate, penultimate, pre-penultimate. So last, second last, third last. Now, after finishing out that, can you carry out electronic configuration of new element I am giving here? Now, this is uranium, naturally occurring last element. Next element is neptunium. Say, what is next planet to Uranus? That is Neptune. So this element is termed as neptunium. Atomic number 93, mass number 239. So you have to focus on 93 electrons and try to write down electronic configuration of plutonium here. Neptunium here, atomic number 93. Pause this video. First try to carry out electronic configuration yourself, then observe my video again. All right, check out. Those who are clever, they can immediately say it is 93. That means last electron should enter here instead of 5F4. Everything is same. Only reminder here is 5. So I have to write down, in case of plutonium, I have to change this way, that in case of plutonium, I should say electron is here. So it is 5F5. So this shell is not affected, this is not affected, this is not affected. The affected is only 5F. So we are calling this shell as shell under construction. So which is shell under construction? 5F is shell under construction. So here, now next element I am giving you, you can immediately carry out. Now Pluto is not considered as planet, but in old days, before 2006, it was considered as planet. So, and now also there are people, they are saying that Pluto must be considered as planet. So here Pluto, we can keep in mind Uranus, Neptune, Pluto. So anyway, uranium, neptunium, plutonium, atomic number 94 and mass number suppose 239. Carry out electronic configuration of this element. You can immediately say only here make 5F6. That's all. All right. So that's why we are calling this as shell under construction. So shell under construction is pre-penultimate shell, ultimate shell and ultimate shell and penultimate shell are remaining stagnant. Stagnant means here it is as it is, whereas shells are filled out, that is third last shell. This is about above principle. Now once you have carried out this all, now check out why I explained you this all difficult task first. Because now whatever exercise I am going to give you, that will be very, very easy for you. Let us check out that exercise. After this tremendous high exercise, we are switching over to somewhat simpler exercise over here. I want to ask you about electronic configuration of chlorine, atomic number 7 and mass number 37. Now try to carry out electronic configuration yourself. Pause this video, carry out yourself electronic configuration, and again switch on video, observe. It is 17 electrons I had to fill out. So it's very simple now. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p. Now here 10 electron, 12 electron, remainder 5. So 3p, 5. So it's very simple for you now. You can check out electronic configuration of hydrogen. Atomic number 1, mass number 1. So electronic configuration 1s1, no further. If I am talking of helium, 2, 4. Then atomic number is 2. So electronic configuration is 1s2 and like that. So this is very, very simple for you, that we can check out electronic configuration of any of these element. Now, it is not always so simple. Some complications are there, and we are now switching over to another complication that we are calling as p orbital split. First, carry out electronic configuration of element phosphorus, atomic number 15. So I am giving you phosphorus, atomic number 15, mass number 31. So first try to carry out electronic configuration of this element. I am removing out all these other things. If I am going to carry out this configuration, it is very simple. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, till that 10 plus 2, 12 electrons. So 3 electrons are there. So I have to say it is 3p3. This electronic configuration is no doubt right. But I want further detail. Now keep in mind, when p orbital is last orbital, I am revising, when p orbital is last orbital, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. This is right. But keep in mind, when p orbital is last orbital, condition number 1, p orbital is last orbital and it is incompletely filled. Say if it is p equal to 6, then I should say it completely. It is not 6, therefore I have to say it is incompletely filled. Then this principle is applied. This principle is called as p orbital splitting, or more correctly, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. The word I am using here, that is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Very, very, very simple rule is there. Say, I have to split out p orbital. For that purpose, I am showing you a box. Keep in mind, in this lecture, whatever we are discussing, that is very, very important, fundamental part. So try to understand meaning of each and every word. No doubt, I am aware that your mother tongue is not English. Obviously, my is also not English. But still, scientific terminology is there. So we have to understand various concepts over here. So it is 3p3. I am splitting out into this part. This orbital is there. It is named as 3px. why we will discuss later. Right now, try to get concept first. So it is 3px, this is 3py, and obviously chronologically this is 3pz, alphabetically, sorry, this is 3pz. Now these three orbitals are split out in this way, whereas this is box diagram, but I am showing all three orbitals attached together. This is the situation. We are calling this as degenerated orbitals. What word I am using here? Degenerated orbitals. What is the meaning of degenerated orbitals? That orbitals having same energy. If energy is same, we are calling that as degenerated orbitals. Revising. So let us check out another example. Suppose you are traveling by a bus. Public bus is there. You are traveling by a bus. Then you will get clear-cut idea that once you are entering in that bus, say suppose your fare is of 100 rupees. To travel a distance of say 50 kilometer, you are spending out 100 rupees. Then by giving that 100 rupees, you can sit on any available seat in the bus. The bus fare is not like that. Suppose you are sitting just behind the driver's seat, then it will be 200 rupees. If you are sitting on last seat, then it will be 50 rupees. No, the bus fare is same. After paying that bus fare, you can sit on any seat available. Getting idea? So this is the degeneracy. But suppose you are traveling by train, then by giving that fare, you are not supposed to enter in any compartment. Suppose you are having ordinary ticket, general class ticket, and you are entering in reservation class, then fine is there. No doubt you have paid the ticket, you have paid the fare from point A to point B, but your selection of compartment is also important. Suppose you have ordinary sleeper class ticket, reservation, and you are entering in AC compartment, then also not valid. If you are having fare ticket of 3-tier AC and you are entering into 2-tier AC, then also not valid. Like that, concepts are there. So here, what is degeneracy? Electron once entered here, it can free to move anywhere if space is available, like our bus fare. Once I am entering in the bus, I can sit anywhere in the bus on available seat if reservations are not there. Now, three electrons are there. First electron is sitting here. Alphabetically, X comes first, therefore I am giving you here. Otherwise, it can be anywhere. That's why these orbitals are called as degenerated orbital. Now, what is the 3s2? So here I am showing you 3s2 orbital. This is 3s. So first electron is here, second electron is here only. Why? I have shown here a gap. What is the meaning of that? These orbitals are not degenerated. 3s is having different energy, and 3px, 3py, 3pz, they are having different energy. The energy line moves like this. So here lower energy, here higher energy. And so one electron is filled over here, next electron must filled over here. But this is called as spin direction. Now keep in mind, in any such orbital, two electrons are accommodated. One will spin clockwise, then other will spin anti-clockwise. So this way, I am showing half part here, or half arrow that is moving clockwise, and half will move anti-clockwise. Now in case of 3px, alphabetically I am placing this here, but actually speaking, it can move anywhere here. Now second electron, because I have to accommodate three electrons. Second electron, can I place here? Because as I am placing here, same way I can place here. But here that rule is important. This rule is called as Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. What this rule states? That when degenerated orbitals are available, electrons try to remain unpaired as far as possible. Say, what word is there? As far as possible. So here, this electron will not move here. Instead of that, this can be here or here. alphabetically I am placing second electron over here, and third electron obviously, as there is no other place here, because degenerated orbital is available. So electrons can move anywhere here as far as possible. Now this is the electronic configuration. So how I should write down this? So instead of writing 3p this way, I should split out this as 3px1. So 3px belong electron 1 is there for 3py. So I have to write 3py1 and 3pz1. So what I have to write, the electronic configuration of phosphorus is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. But instead of writing 3p3, I have to write 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1. Getting idea? So this is called as, by applying Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, this is the electronic configuration. Now check out your chlorine electronic configuration. Just now we carried out the configuration of chlorine, atomic number 17, and there we have written 3p5, last electron. So if last electron is there, that is 3p5, then how I can adjust 3s2 as it is, no question, 3p5. So already three electrons I have adjusted like this. The fourth electron, where it should give go? Now there is no degenerated orbital is available, then electrons start pairing out. The fourth electron will pair like this. Alphabetically we are preferring out to X. Fifth electron will pair like this. The sixth electron remain unpaired. So what is the configuration of chlorine? So 3px2, 3py2, 3pz1. So this is the electronic configuration of chlorine. Getting idea? This rule is called as Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. So in this electronic configuration, we discuss about number one, that is Aufbau principle, number two, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity.